Hello friends, I explained theory regarding this chapter in the previous video. Now we are starting small sums of this chapter. Small sums of this chapter is given in the page number 30 of the textbook. You can see that. Okay, now see, the first sum is that a partner withdraws identical amount at the end of each month from the firm. At the end of the year, total annual drawings is 12,000. 12% per annum interest is chargeable. That means rate of interest is given here on the drawings. Determine the amount of interest on the drawings of the year. That means this is the question that we have to find out. Now see, in this question it is given that a partner withdraws identical amount, that means same amount, at the end of each month. There is two types of questions can be asked in the examination, that is at the end of each month and at the beginning of each month. This kind of question is asked at that time. Formula is used, which is written here. Interest on drawings is equal to monthly drawings into rate of interest into number of months. So first of all, say here, annual drawings, that means yearly drawings is given 12,000. So first of all, we have to convert into monthly drawings. So monthly drawings is equal to 12,000 divided by 12, which comes to 1,000. So I am writing here 1,000 into rate of interest, which is mentioned in this sum, that is 12%, and number of months. So how this number of months will be calculated? This calculation is given here. Monthly drawings, do remember, at the beginning of each month or at the end of each month. Both the calculation I have written here. So first of all, drawings in the beginning of each month. You have to see that beginning of each month. That means if any partner withdraws money on 1/4, that means 1st April. So we'll calculate 1st April to 31st March, because our year ended on which? 31st March. So 1st April to 31st March, how many months are there? That is 12 months. Then 1st May to 31st March, 11 months. 1st June to 31st March, that is 10 months. So on, this calculation will be done. When we do total of this month, that comes to 78 months. How many? 78 months. That means when the drawings in the beginning of each month is given, at the time interest will be calculated for the 78 month. That means n is equal to 78 divided by 12. Same way, calculation for the drawings at the end of each month. See, end of each month, that means our April month ended on 30th date. So I've written here 34, then May month is ended on 31st May, so 31st May, 30th June, 31st, 7, 31, 8, so on. So first of all, 34 to year ended on 31st March, so 34 to 31st March, how many months are there? That is 11 months. Then 31st 5 to 31st March, 10 months. 36 to 31st March, 9 months. So on, this calculation will be done. At last, 31st March to 31st March, 0 month will be there. That's why I have written here 0 month. If we do total, then 66 month will be covered. So here, n is taken as 66 divided by 12. Now see, in this sum, it is given that identical amount at the end of each month. At the end of each month. That means our n should be 66 divided by 12. So here I am writing 66 divided by 12. Now the calculation, that is 1000 into 12% into 66 divided by 12. Answer will become 660, that is 660 rupees. I hope you all.